Scientists all over the world have been working to create a supercomputer that can solve the most complex problems using concepts of quantum physics, where more than one reality or state of being can exist. The world's first commercial quantum computer has landed in Seoul today to mark the progress made after decades of research in the field. Our Soo-young has the story.
It looks like a golden chandelier. But you're not seeing shards of glass. It's the model of the world's first commercial quantum computer on display in the Korean capital on Tuesday. Quantum computers are being developed around the world to process information and solve problems that are extremely difficult or even impossible for standard computers.
Maybe something that might take 1,000 years, 1,000,000 years on a classical computer, you could do in a few minutes, a few hours, or maybe a few days with a quantum computer. And we think that will happen across a range of industries. It could be the creation of brand new materials. They could be household materials, but they could be new metal alloys for cars, for airplanes. They could eventually be new drugs for medicines. Financial services is another area, so banks are very interested in that.
The IBM Q may have provided a conceptual turning point, expanding quantum computing beyond the walls of the lab. But when it comes to outperforming a regular computer on meaningful tasks or achieving the so-called quantum advantage, most scientists say we still need more time.
Normal computers store data in binary form as either ones or zeros. However, quantum computers use a unit called a qubit, which can exist as a one and a zero at the same time in what's called a state of superposition. As both possibilities exist, this increases the amount of data the computer can store or process, meaning it can run through all possible outcomes at once. However, it's not just the number of qubits that matter. Keeping them in a workable state or coherence time is one of the biggest hurdles in quantum computing.
We have to convert the number of qubits into effective number of qubits. So what is important is a connection between the qubits. So if you have more connections between the qubits, then you have higher capacity to handle more complex problem. We envision that the real practical applications will be found once the machines achieve 100 qubit level.
Despite the complications, researchers and firms are striving to harness the quantum advantage, which could take the AI revolution and data clouds to a whole new realm.
Already, the flow of data across countries is adding more to the global economy compared to the trade of actual manufacturing goods. And that'll also form a basis for solving society's biggest problems, like how to better cure cancer, how to better forecast weather so we can actually save lives.
While quantum computers are unlikely to replace standard ones for decades, if ever, scientists say it's clear that a new era of computing has begun. Arirang, Arirang News.